I deal with various disorders of the joints and spine, both inflammatory and non-inflammatory. And I'll be picking up rheumatoid arthritis as an example, where I would like to highlight some of the learnings of Ashwagandha. I must share with you that I'm a modern medicine physician. My research interest is in Ayurveda, primarily to do drug trials and do mechanism actions and study the interaction between rheumatology in Ayurveda and rheumatology in modern medicine. I do not practice Ayurveda. I've been a principal investigator for several studies. What I'm going to present is about Ayurvedic formulations as plant extracts. I'm not going to present any clinical data on fractions or a part of the plant. Everything that I say will pertain to the whole plant extract, whether it's aqueous or whether it's alcohol. So in my very first experience, which was way back in 1996, this was set up with Mass General Hospital in US. This was an Indo-American study. We chose to evaluate a Ayurvedic formulation which contained Ashwagandha, Gugul, Shunti, that is ginger, and Haldi, which is turmeric. This formulation was basically conceptualized, made, standardized, evaluated both in the laboratory and animals by Professor Bhushan Patwardhan, who will be soon joining us. So this formulation was handed over to us, and we made a standard of a standard rheumatoid arthritis protocol, and just the way we would look at modern medicine. This was my very first study where we wanted to actually see what kind of evidence do we have about Ayurvedic medicine's effectiveness or efficacy in this case. So this is a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled study in a large number of patients that you can see who were naive for any kind of disease-modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs, and they were all enrolled from the community. It's the intent to treat analysis. The name of the formulation was given as RA1. Now, this was a 12-week study. Some patients were allowed a small dose of steroids. Both the groups were very well matched, the RA1 and the placebo. At the end of the study, we could not find a statistically significant difference in the primary efficacy variable, which was a kind of an index improvement. But we could see that the Ayurvedic formulation was ahead of the placebo in every possible variable. The joint counts for pain tenderness, the joint counts for swelling, the global assessments by patient and physician, the pain measured on visual analog scale, HAQ, which is health assessment questionnaire, a functional instrument, and the sedimentation rate. And we also found there was a significant effect on the rheumatoid factor, which is one of the biological key markers of arthritis. So though we could not, though the study by the modern medicine standards was not successful, but there are enough clues to indicate that the Ayurvedic formulation was effective, much superior to placebo. So beyond this, we went into a long three-year study, which I did in Pune. Out of 182, almost 165 patients agreed to continue beyond 3 months. And beyond 3 months, it's a three-year study. This is perhaps the first study of its kind in the world where patients were told to continue their Ayurvedic medication, background medication, for 3 years in a real-to-life clinical setting. But we rheumatologists could add disease-modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs if the patient flared.
Yes.
Just to tell you something, there's a lot of data, but I would like to come to the most critical part of the study. This is published in the Journal of Ayurvedic Integrative Medicine, a peer-reviewed journal. At the end of 3 years, we have enough data to demonstrate that the Ayurvedic drug could control rheumatoid arthritis at least in 30-40% of patients per se as monotherapy. There were patients who required methotrexate and or chloroquine. Some required intermittent steroids, but we could manage the rheumatoid arthritis very effectively for 2 years. There were no drug interactions. We have recorded several adverse events. There were no differences, significant differences. None of the patients in the RA1 Ayurvedic formulation ever left these studies because of any adverse event due to drug. So to conclude, this was the very first experience where we could demonstrate that then a standardized Ayurvedic herbal formulation is an effective and safe anti-inflammatory and disease-modifying drugs in the management of diabetes. This is also some kind of integrative medicine approach where we are demonstrating for the first time that one could use Ayurvedic medicines along with modern medicines in a very judicious manner. I come several years later, Bhushan and myself get an opportunity to design and execute a very big research project called Nimitli, which was in the earlier when in the government of D.H.D. Bajpayee ji. This was one of the flagship program of the government of some niche areas where India had an advantage. So in this new millennium Indian Technology Leadership Initiative, Ayurveda was also chosen as a domain. Amongst the target disorders in Ayurveda, arthritis was chosen to also explore and try and validate an Ayurvedic medicine for the treatment of arthritis for global use. That was a mandate given to us. Now, I will not go into the details, but this was a very well-designed program where several premier agencies, clinical and non-clinical agencies, interacted, worked together, something like a Team India approach. It's a parallel development where we were doing clinical evaluations, filtering out, screening out several formulations and trying to find the best formulation. We chose osteoarthritis and knee joint as the primary efficacy, but we also did some work in rheumatoid arthritis. So I present maybe two studies from this, several publications are there. My very first study in this Unity program was a seven-arm study where we have used a Shunti Guduji as a platform formulation and then added various other formulations which from an Ayurvedic perspective are known to work as anti-arthritis, anti-inflammatory, some of them are immune modulators, I'll talk about them. So there was a seven-arm study comparing Ayurvedic formulations with glucosamine and placebo in symptomatic osteoarthritis knees. I want you to be focused on the formulation D, which is the main formulation. Then we added Ashwagandha, Vidhinya, Somanathra, it became E. And to this we further added Gokshul as advised by the Ayurvedic physicians. That is formulation D. So the three formulations which contain Ashwagandha, we'll only look at that. So when we looked at the D formulation, there was a reduction in pain VAS and improvement in pain and functions. When we look at E, which is Shunti Guduchi plus Ashwagandha, there's a dosing effect. Better reduction in pain, more improvement in the function. And finally, when we added Gokshu, that is B, we found that we had even a much superior effect. So it seems that for the first time, we are able to see for ourselves that increase in the dose also improves the effect. One second. I'll just go back. Right. So these seven arms, now you can see the reduction in pain VAS. We'll again focus only on D, which is the core formulation. Then we added Ashwagandha, that becomes B, and you find no difference in both the groups. There's a significant reduction in pain. But when we added Gokshu to Ashwagandha, you can see the dramatic improvement, reduction in pain. These patients were not allowed painkillers. So this was an example or a demonstration over 4 months of very potent anti-pain effect and some protective effect of Ashwagandha. I take you to another study which we did during those days. There is not much data in the Ayurveda on the dosing effects. This was a study where we again used Ashwagandha, that is B plus, and we increased the dose further to B plus. And I'm trying to show that there's a much better response when you increase the dose, but there's a limit to it. We know that we have also data to show that beyond some time, if you increase the dose, you don't get more clinical effect. My colleagues during that period have done a lot of laboratory studies. Here I just bring one example where my colleague Dr. Venil Sumantran, she did some very elegant studies in cell cultures. She did a chondrocyte cell culture in Bharatiya Vidyapeeth in Pune and showed that Ashwagandha also has a protective effect in some patients. She also demonstrated that in some of the cell cultures there is no response. So obviously there is possibly two subsets of patients who donated these cells, that some respond and some don't respond, and some elegant experiments to show that Ashwagandha could inhibit the gelatinase, which is an important enzyme, completely. In the end, I want to again talk about rheumatoid arthritis as part of the Mimicry program. This particular study, perhaps the first time in published literature, showed that ashwagandha was as good or as bad as hydroxychloroquine sulfate, which we used in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis as a disease-modifying anti-rheumatoid drug. In fact, the Ayurvedic formulation that we used here, the acronym was GAGS, G-A-G-S. It was ashwagandha combined to Shunti, Gandhuchi, and Gopsha, the B formulation that you saw earlier. This was a six-month study, open-label study. Here we are comparing with another Ayurvedic formulation called UIT2, which is a proprietary formulation. At the end of 6 months, let me show you that patients of rheumatoid arthritis, symptomatic, active patients with rheumatoid factor positive, with erosions, with deformities, these patients showed a good effectiveness both with the Ayurvedic formulation and hydroxychloroquine. There were no differences, but the Ayurvedic formulation showed a better safety profile. So this itself generated a hypothesis that Ayurvedic medicines, even if they are as effective as modern medicines, certainly the side effect and the tolerability profile goes in favor. Friends, just want to stop this presentation now, saying those of you who perhaps like me, I was a skeptic long time back. There's a lot of stress in Ayurvedic classic literature that we need to validate results. This is one of the quotations from Charaka Samhita, which I read long time back. So, Dr. Agrawal, I'd like to stop here and again maybe go back to the presentation when we talk about COVID-19 and ashwagandha.
Thank you. Can I have